Hey, welcome back. So today I'm going to take a look at HTML and CSS, design and build beautiful websites by John Ducket. Now, this is quite a big book, actually. I was very surprised when I got it. This book presents itself as the nicer way to learn about HTML and CSS. Now, you might be thinking, my boy, is this a good book if I want to learn HTML and CSS? Well, when you just start to open it, you start noticing that this book is very interestingly laid out. Everything is very simply laid out. There are diagrams and codes with examples for pretty much anything you wish to learn. This is H1 to H6, the title tags. Now, I really like how this book is laid out. I am not sure I'm the best person to tell you if this is the best way to learn from a book, HTML and CSS, because when I got this, I was already a web developer. I got this pretty much to complement my actual working knowledge, and I use this more as an encyclopedia, which it works very well as. Let's say I was looking for background color, which, background color is perhaps a little simple for our example. Alright, font formats. Now this is more in-depth. Now if I want to learn about font formats, I could have just typed it on Google. Let's just say that the art of Googling is one of your best assets, the best skills you can learn as a developer, but still, this book has a very easy to understand, very concise page about this. Now, concision is what I really want to stress about this, is that there's no unnecessary content. You get straight up what you need in just a few paragraphs, so you can really cut the time you would take to normally search about it on Google. Granted, you still need to find it in this book, and this book does not cover everything, but there's been at least 5 examples in the last year of me just finding something useful in there. I'm not saying that this is a game changer, and definitely not worth it for me for the $35 Canadian, which is $29.99 US dollars. I don't think this was worth it for me. If you're just trying to learn HTML and CSS, well, this is a good-looking book. It's very well laid out, very simple. Everything you need to learn about HTML seems to be there. Now, HTML is pretty easy to understand, so I don't think you'd have trouble learning HTML from this. CSS, pretty much the same thing. However, the thing is that for this price, you could get online courses. There are very good courses on HTML and CSS. I would recommend you go check especially the Web Developer Bootcamp by Cold Steel, which would cost you only 2/3 of the prices of this book, and you'd get exercises on top of it. The best way to remember something is actually to do it, not to read it, not to memorize it. Just think about school. In school, you learn about all this shit, and after 1 year of not using it, you just forget all of it. Think about your history classes. How much of your history classes you remember? Probably very fucking little. And this is the same with all that you memorize, all that you read about. If you don't use, if you don't try everything that you read in this book, it's just gonna get out of your mind and you're not gonna be able to use it very effectively. So most of your understanding, most of your long-term knowledge will come from practice. And what's really good about the Web Developer Bootcamp, which is what I recommend you that you get instead of this book, is that you get very good exercises which test all the things that you need to learn about HTML and CSS. And these exercises are fun, and they're very varied, and you get to practice pretty much everything you learn. Now, one of them is even like some sort of keyboard musical instrument that you program through using your keyboard. There's some making some blogs, making some sample websites. Really, I can't stress enough how practicing this shit is important. And the problem with this book is not that it presents it very bad, but I think that the book format is not the best way to learn HTML and CSS. So if you're interested in getting this book, you can get it on Amazon, links in the description. As I said, it's not a bad book. Definitely best for beginners, not intermediates nor experts. As I said, go on Udemy, get a HTML and CSS course, hopefully the one I'm recommending. Links in the description for that as well. And Yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Not a bad book, but it's not the best option for you out there, according to me. So, if you have books or online courses you want us to review, just write them in the comments down below. If you have questions about anything, about this book, about online learning as well, I encourage you to write them in the description. I'll be very happy to respond as soon as I can. With that said, thank you again for watching. My name is Alec Gagne, and I'll see you soon.